This Drake Law Library video will show you how to view hidden characters and apply styles in the template that we created in Microsoft Word for your use for the appellate brief. You can find that template and more at the brief formatting libguide referenced on this slide. This is the brief template. First, I want to show you the Show Hide Paragraph button. It's on the Home tab and it looks like this. It's a toggle button, so it turns on and then off. When I click to turn it on, it shows the characters that would otherwise be hidden, such as paragraph markers and tabs. When I turn it off, those things are still there, but they're not visible. I recommend that you have the hidden characters on at least each time you start a new section, because at the end of every section, there's a page break that is either just a page break or a page break with a section break. The section breaks help control the different kind of pagination in the brief, so as you move from the Roman numeral pagination into the Arabic pagination, that's controlled by the section breaks, and it would be very easy to accidentally delete these if they're not visible. I've jumped ahead to the argument section so we can look at styles. To the template, I have added some text so we can see how styles are applied. Styles are defined sets of formatting instructions that you can define and then apply to quickly and consistently format different kinds of text in a document. Styles are also found on the Home tab in the Styles box, and the template has 5 styles defined. Paragraphs are what you'll use for the regular paragraphs in your brief, and then there are headings 1, 2, 3, and 4, which are used for different heading levels. The template already has all the main headings that divide the brief into different components, such as argument, and these all already have heading 1 applied to them. However, for all of your point headings, you're going to need to apply the styles yourself. So here's something that I want to be a main point heading. I select it, and then I'm going to pick heading 2. Heading 2 puts the selected text in all caps and numbers it at the Roman numeral outline level. For subheadings, you're going to use heading 3, so you can select your subheading and then click on heading 3. This will place the text at the capital letter level of the outline. However, note that title case is not baked into the style, so that's something you're going to have to manually correct if you did not already type your heading in title case. In order to do this, I'm going to use the Change Case tool. I'm going to select capitalize each word, and then I can manually modify where I don't actually want capital letters. Once I get that the way I want it, I can move on to my next heading. So I'm going to show you what a sub-subheading looks like. You select that, and then you're going to select heading 4. That will place the heading at the Arabic numeral level of the outline. You're going to also need to ensure that this is in sentence case. I've applied styles to the rest of these headings so that you can see that by applying the styles, you get the correct automatic numbering, and that numbering will carry over into the table of contents. A separate video details how to finalize the table of contents. Thanks for watching.